something down and it's like, damn, this beat is banging. I know you know what I'm talking about, Uncle Nick. You want to write this shit down and it's like, fuck. It won't come out, but it's in my head. It's all right there in my head, but it just won't come out. Like, fuck. I know you feel me, Steph. You be like, I want to take this picture, but damn, I thought maybe it would have been like this, but no, fuck. I love, no. I hate my life. I hate being an artist. So writer's block is basically a short film, a documentary, talking about when your mind go blank. And then after that, we're going to do a live visual installation art piece curated by my brother Louis Vaughn called August the Terrible. This presentation is only an hour, but it's going to feel like 29 years. It's going to feel good. It's going to inspire you because it inspired me. Writer's block. Art saved my life. You know, I'm looking at that and it showed my progress as an artist. It showed my progress as a man. Especially coming on the Chicago scene in 99. And at a time when people said you couldn't do certain things as a hip hop artist, especially coming out of Inglewood, it was like, no, fuck you, man. I don't want to wear, you know, I'm not knocking that, but I'm not no backpacker. You know what I'm saying? I didn't just grow up on KRS-One. I grew up on soul music. I grew up on, like, you know what I'm saying? Just the Ozzy Brothers. And then coming from Inglewood, you know what I'm saying? You got Dipset. You got Triple Six Mafia. You got, you know, my knowledge, man, of Chicago hip hop was Drama Ward, Crucial Conflict, Big Nasty, DJ Sluggo, DJ Gantman. And then the trans, once I got into African dancing with my, with Miss Darlene Blackburn, piece to my tool, that exposed me to culture. It exposed me to, like, yo, I could leave Inglewood and, like, yo, this shit is fly as hell, you know what I'm saying? African dancing, you know what I'm saying? Wicker Park, Cinnabar, Square One. All this dope shit, man. And it's like, you know what I'm saying? But it's something about Inglewood that still got me. You know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, I want to still be in Inglewood. You know what I'm saying? Because you try to tell yourself, like, yo, you don't want to sell out. You don't want your people to think you left the hood. But then when my cousin got murdered, got changed, you know, I went up to all the dudes in my hood that was running the block. And you got to understand, I was a space cadet out of my hood. You know what I'm saying? Everybody loved me and respect me for being different, but knew at the same time I would whoop your ass if you disrespect me. But they was like, yo, drunk, you know, pork chop, get out the hood. You're intelligent, get out the hood. You ain't a vice lord, get out the hood. You ain't a mole, get out the hood. You ain't GD, get out the hood. So it was like, yo. And looking at that, it just made me just like, yo, like, damn, G, like, I did that with my phone. You know what I'm saying? That, you know, I was like that kid that was, like, too white for my black friends, but they loved me. And to my white friends, I was too black for them. So I always been a monkey in the middle. So it was like, yo, when I seen this movie called Blank City, it was talking about the transgression scene that was going on in New York in, like, late 70s, early 80s. You know what I'm saying? When it was about the Ramones, when it was about Basquiat, when it was about Five Freddy, when it was about just, like, being an artist, being broke, living in abandoned buildings, and doing this style, 8mm style. I'm a fan of black and white photography. It's something about black and white photography, Gordon Park, something about photography. It's beautiful to me, so I'm like, yo, I'm gonna do this film 8mm style, because one, I don't have a 5D camera, and I wanna do something different at a time where everybody like, yo, it gotta be clean, it gotta be crisp, it gotta be this, it gotta be 5D, it gotta be Blu-ray. I'm like, you know what, fuck that, I don't have access to that. I'm not about to pay $500 for something that I could do. So I created that. And man, just looking at it, it feel good, man. So clap it up once again. So I know y'all like, yo, why the hell do y'all got like this shit right here? You know what I'm saying? Like I said, it's a I'm a space cadet. You know what I'm saying? Tweet Central Academy is that movement. Tweet Central Academy is about embracing your space cadet, embracing the difference in you. You know what I'm saying? Be who you supposed to be. Be who God made you to be. You know what I'm saying? So it was like, yo, my dude Louis Vaughn came to me with this project. Now we moving in the future where we got 5D. We got some Blu-ray clear visual next level shit. He's like, yo, I want you to be in this movie with me. And I'm like, cool. You know what I'm saying? What you want to do? And he was like, yo, we gotta go to the woods. And you just gotta do some wild, crazy shit. So I'm like, okay. There's something about the woods. When it comes to the woods, I always think about one of my favorite poets. I am that one voice crying out of the wilderness. His name was John the Baptist. So when it comes to like the woods, it remind me of the wilderness. And it's like, yo, when I got in there, it was like, yo, it was something just taking over my body where it was all this animation, all this craziness just hitting me, just energy. And we did this film called August the Terrible. Some people, when you look at it, they be like, what is it? You know what I'm saying? Is it a visual installation? What is it about? Is it about some crazy Satan shit? Is it about, you know what I'm saying, somebody taking acid, being in the wood, tweaking out? Like, what is this film about? It's about what it is to you, but it's about the spiritual battle that people go through. Your good side, your bad side, your higher side, your lower side. It's about what everybody go through. So this next installation that we get ready to do, which is the last one, is called August the Terrible. This one is going to be a little bit different from the first one because this one includes live visual performance, where you're going to have the visual going on the screen, and at the same time, you're going to see just crazy acting, improvisation. Don't be afraid, just go with the flow. Say go with the flow.
Go with the flow.
Go with the flow.
Go with the flow.
So we presents, Louis Vaughn presents August the Terrible. Yes.
Thank you.
trying to free myself. I'm trying to free myself from poverty, from frustration, from stress. I'm trying to free myself.
I search high, now I'm going lower. And here come them demons again. Every time I get close to God, every time I get close to peace, every time I get close to sanity, here come them demons again.
Shooter. sensitive. You might not believe this, I had very sensitive ears. So I'm not really trying to hear all that.
Shut the fuck up. Ain't no fucking God, shut the fuck up.
You know, some of them are quiet though. Some of them. Those are the ones that I really like the one I was telling you about earlier with the white, and that little bitch with the watch, yeah. Yeah, you know, easy, just easy, you know. I am the last person that these motherfuckers see. I'm the last person that they see. And then when I kill them, when I take their soul, you know what I'm saying?
It was too late.
Well, my relationship with God is like, well, what's your relationship with something that you really care about? What would you feel like, you know, something that you really care about was taken away, and the people now are acting like it's not around? You know, how would you feel about that? I mean, when you should think about that. That's my answer too.
Find peace. I can find God.
firm now? I believe in God. Oh, you believe in God even though the Bible ain't real? I believe in God. How do you know? I believe in God. How do you know? I believe in God. How do you know? Because I feel him in my heart. Rotates and beats you up inside. Fear God. You can feel God. You're just not listening.
Train my body, I must train my mind and my spirit. I must train. I must focus on my breathing. I gotta train. They're killing us in the streets. Even though I gave them love, even though I gave them peace, even though we marched in peace, even though we protest in peace, I feel I must train. So I'm focusing on my chi. I'm training. I'm on strain. I'm on strain.
spiritual man. I'm a man of God. I have children I must protect. They take away our guns. And I don't want to use a gun, so I'd rather use my body as my gun, as my weapon. And I must train. My daughters are getting older. My daughters are developing into young women. And I have to teach them how to train. My son is getting older, and right now the world look at him as an adorable little boy. But once he get older, they gonna look at him as another nigga. So I must teach him how to train. Train. I don't want my daughters to be caught out there. only the call out there. I must train. I must train. I must train. I must train. Clap it up for Mr. Cooper. For my Uncle Mike, too. So like I was saying, like poetry, art saved my life. Growing up in Inglewood, art saved my life. Like I told the people yesterday in my neighborhood, I was that kid that was too white for my black friends. And to my friends, other races, I was too black for them. I was always that monkey in the middle. And poetry saved my life. Right now, we living in a time where it's like you got all this generation, this young generation that's just angry. That's just angry, that just wanna fight, that just wanna fight. And if it weren't for African dancers showing me to express my anger in another way, if it wasn't for martial arts showing me how to express myself in another way, I would probably be dead, I would probably be shot, I would probably be locked up, no telling where I'd be. And you gotta understand, taking art from the school system, they know what they're doing.
Yeah, they do.
Taking art away from our kids, they know what they're doing. How they gonna express themselves? You taking away the basketball courts, you taking away the playgrounds, you taking away the art in the school, so, and my mother and my father, they always at work, so how am I going to express myself and self, go out here and do something that I don't want to do because the streets love me? My mother and my father, they work all the time, God bless them, so who else going to take care of me? The streets is calling me, so I'm going to go to the streets. But it's something about poetry. Poetry is expression. Poetry is all about embracing the inner self in you and letting it out in a good way. This next piece that you're getting ready to see is from a beautiful, beautiful young lady that I love very much. I met her in 1999, and since I've been with her, I've been a better man. I've been a focused man. Have mercy on my soul, Miss Asia Monique.
Woo! Ow!
City and I keep hearing something going. Closer, I keep walking. And as I keep walking, I see this figure walking towards me, and I really can't see what it is walking towards me. And as I'm walking towards it, it's small and it get bigger and bigger. It's getting bigger and bigger. It's getting bigger and bigger. It's getting bigger and bigger. And as I look, it's like, radio. It's a big radio. And the radio is looking at me, and it got these red big eyes with these vampire type of teeth, and it's growling, and it's coming towards me. And all of a sudden the radio start coming towards me. The radio start coming towards me, and it's getting bigger, and it's getting bigger, and I start running. I'm running from this radio. This radio is chasing me. This radio is chasing me. And I'm running. 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 This big radio is chasing me. And I'm in a dark city all by myself. And nowhere, no one is around. And I'm getting scared as this radio is chasing me. And as I look, this radio got these, this I Am Legend type of creatures. They throwing contracts at me. They throwing CDs at me. They throwing drugs at me. They throwing police at me. They throwing all these crazy frequencies at me. And I'm running, and I'm screaming, and ah, help, help, help. It's a big radio chasing me, and I don't know what to do, and I hit my head around, and I'm scared. Why are you chasing me? Chasing me, and as the radio is starting to come after me, I see a dragon pop up on my shoulder, saying nobody will like you if you're not watered down the mainstream. Nobody like the truth. Nobody like the truth. And as I'm listening to this voice, this radio is still chasing me, and I hear all these voices saying nobody like the truth. Dumb yourself down. Dumb yourself down. Dumb your music down. Don't talk about the truth. I'm screaming, ain't nobody around, I'm scared. I'm scared. And as I look at this radio, it got these I Am Legend type of creatures on his shoulder. And it's doing, as I look at this radio, it's got these I Am Legend type of creatures on it. And it's throwing contracts at me. It's throwing drugs at me. It's throwing fake stuff at me. It's giving me a crazy frequency. And as I look, I see these zombies. I see these zombies with headphones walking towards me, saying nobody will like you if you're not watered down the mainstream. Nobody like the truth. Nobody like good music. And I start to feel cornered. I started to feel cornered as this radio is chasing me, as he's dragging on my shoulder, telling me no one will love me if I'm not watered down the mainstream. So I drop to my knees and I'm, God, please save my soul. I'm just trying to keep my sanity. I'm just trying to keep my purity. I'm not trying to make music. That's not me. This radio is coming on me. Started to come close to me, I realized I like making good music. I don't want to do something that's not me. So as the radio come towards me, and it's throwing these fake contracts, throwing all these drugs at me, I lay myself down and say, I'm going to let the radio take me, because I'm not going to sell my soul. I like being me. I don't want to talk about drugs. I don't want to talk about negative things. I don't want to talk about things that's not me. I'd rather keep my purity and let my radio go ahead and just eat me. It's not about money, it's all spiritual. You have to be a crazy spiritual messed up person to be like, you know what, I'm going to GMO millions of people food, I'm going to put all this stuff in there, I'm going to do this, and I know it's going to make the people weak, I know it's going to kill them off, but you know what, I want the whole world to be my playground. That's spiritual war. My God! There's no God. This, that. Everything in nature is in tune to subhuman beings. Mm-hmm. I said this last night. The sun come out when it's supposed to. The moon come out when it's supposed to. Seasons change when it's supposed to. But when it comes to human beings, we are the ones who mess up God's word. We are the ones that go hard on something like, no, there is no God. I am God. No, it ain't that, it ain't this, that's, you know what, I am God, and what you're talking about, I'm not hearing you. And that's why I said peace to Donald Trump and his followers. Who are you to say, yo, let's ban all Muslims from coming in this world? Who are you to say, yo, let's ban all Christians from doing this? Who are you to say, yo, that's crazy because they worship Buddhism? Who are you trying to be God? See, it ain't God, it's us. We the ones messing this up. We the ones building these factories spreading pollution. We the ones going to war over oil. We the ones going to war over money. We the ones going to war over these materialistic things when all we have to do is love. That's it. It's easy. Love have no color. Love have no limitations. Love is what it is. Mr. Cleo, when you met Miss Husband, it was because of love. When I met you, it was because of love. Harmony, when I kissed you, it was because of love. My aunt, as much as you pushed me away, you're like, no. It's because I still hug you because I love you. You wrote your book, Miss Dana, because of love. Cujo, you train, and you go out there and train these kids because you love. Ken, you put all this money into this show because of love. Auntie T, you put up with him because of love. Love is very beautiful. Love is God, and God is love. So what's so wrong with us loving? What's so wrong with us being peace? What's so wrong with us just being peace and being love? This next poem is called Sister Full Moon. It's talking about love. It's talking about, I wanted to write a poem. You gotta understand, when it comes to poetry, like I said, Gil Scott, that's my guy, that's my dude. He made a poem about living in a bottle. And he put funk to it. Living in a bottle. And I was like, you know what? That's what I want to do. I want to do that. I want to make my poetry fun. I don't want to just be up there like, you know. And I'm not knocking anybody, but I wanted to do something where I was animated. I wanted to do something where I screamed, where I sweat, where I presented my heart to the people, because that's what I do. I present my heart. I really don't care about what people say about me or anything, because I'm in tune to what God want me to do. And I put my heart out there because that's where God lives. He lives in your heart. And I was like, I want to do a poem talking about Sister Full Moon and the sun in a relationship. Mm-hmm. This next piece is dedicated to love. You're beautiful. I wanted to make something about love. You don't have to change who you are for love. Love accepts you for who you are. Your parents may not agree with who you dated. The world may not agree with who you with. This person may not agree. That person may not agree. But your heart agree, and that's all that matters. Because love is God, and God is love. Love is God, and God is love. So what are you changing for, Sister Full Moon? Tonight was dedicated to the ancestors. Tonight was for y'all. Now come into the wilderness with me. Divine, so
Thank you.
change.